God amid the billows. Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquieted within me? Psalm 42:5. The writer of Psalm 42 was sad and discouraged. The struggles of life threatened to pull him under and take another victory. But at just the right time, the writer made this decision. Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him. I will remember you from the land of Jordan, and from the heights of Hermon, from the hill Mizar. There is resolve in those words. I shall yet, I will remember you. The writer made a deliberate decision to treat his downcast soul with thoughts of God. Everywhere I go, I will remember you. In your case, the verse would read, from the ICU to the cemetery, to the unemployment line to the courtroom, I will remember you. There is nothing easy about this. Troubles pounce on us like rain in a thunderstorm. Finding God amid the billows will demand every bit of discipline you can muster, but the result is worth the strain. Besides, do you really want to meditate on your misery? Will reciting your problems turn you into a better person? No, but changing your mindset will. Stop allowing yourself to be agitated and disturbed, John 14:27. Instead, immerse your mind in God thoughts.